Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to another edition of Phil's Five. As you can see, I'm back in the office and out of vacation this week. And man, there's a lot of things getting going out there. And, you know, like you, I'm concerned about the rising case counts that we're seeing in the Dallas area and across the state. But I also want to emphasize that this isn't a time to panic. It's a time to be vigilant here. We've got to make sure that you know, we don't let these things scare us out of our wits. We need to have them scare us into our wits. That means that we just really have to make sure once again to put our best foot forward, have all the protocols in place. And that's where I'm going to start with what the Dallas Builders Association has going on this week. First, we've got a really extraordinary video that's going to be a part of the punch list here this week. And it really just explains why we do what we do as a housing industry. And now is a really good time to have a reminder of that and how we're working to keep the industry safe, essential, and professional. Everything that we do here at the Dallas BA has been dedicated to that and dedicated to enabling you to be your best through this crisis that we've got a long way to go through, unfortunately. But we're going to do it, and we're going to do it better together. In that regard, we also have a response kit that I know several of you have been using. That's something that you need to check right now because it's got, again, those best practices out there that you should be implementing over the next few months as you have over the last few on your job sites to make sure that we have the social distancing and the sanitization procedures in place. It also walks through the OSHA recording and reporting requirements if, heaven forbid, there is somebody who turns up with a case of COVID-19 on your site, whether or not it is workplace related or not. That guide has a way of just walking you through those procedures and what you need to do if those cases do indeed occur. So be sure to check that out. Again, that's dallasbuilders.org/COVID-19. Also, in case you missed them, we have a few classes that are available on demand on our website. The At Project Site class, Attention to Inspection Detail, that Donnie Mack and Craig Brooks did. That's up there, as is How to Avoid Getting Stuck in Stucco Litigation that Brian Eubanks and James Rudnicki did. So visit the education page at dallasbuilders.org for more information on that. Also, we've got some upcoming classes in July, very active month coming up for our virtual classes. We've got Building a Better House on July 9th, a certification class with risk management on the 21st, and on the 23rd, a Basics of Building, which is a part of the CGA, CGP, and Master CSP designation. How's that for a lot of alphabet soup? Good certification class there on the 23rd. Again, dallasbuilders.org is where you go for that. Big thanks to Structure being our year-long education partner, among other things, here at the association. And last but not least, our 2003 fun fact. That is when Kent Conine became the first and only member of the Dallas Builders Association to ascend to the chairmanship of NAHB. Kent's been a real mentor to me over the years, somebody who I've got an immense amount of respect for. He's still actively involved, has been helping us with our congressional meetings this week, and it's amazing just to think of all the contributions that he's made, and we've certainly recognized him as a Texas Housing Hall of Honor winner, Hugh Prather Award, among other things. So hats off to you, Kent, and my message to all of you is to make sure still be diligent out there. Make sure you've got your I's dotted, your T's crossed. Check out those resources. We're here to help with personal protective equipment and anything you need. Just hit up our office, and we're happy to answer any questions. So stay safe out there, and I'll talk to you next week. Bye.